You are watching M.A.T.O. episode 13. Here I have a display, two brothers, Loki and Thor, together. Here I'm trying to depict Thor making a sacrifice by seemingly handing over his hammer in the form of a sacrifice for the sake of their brotherhood. So this was something inspired by a display I saw of that book nice did of his Loki and Thor figure. I think his was even more impressive because he added a frost giant in the background. But for me, I think I usually do very simple displays, and I thought this was something that I quite liked. I think I did a shot that was on the A.C.B.A. page. I think if I'm not wrong, it was something like in this angle. So just a simple display I did with existing figures. You know, these guys are not exactly new. Pretty slow week collecting wise. So more updates to come soon. It's the eve of Labor Day. Came home after a long day. I went around window shopping, couldn't find any new fix. But lo and behold, when I opened my mailbox, Arnim Zola was there waiting for me. So this is a BAF figure that I bought recently from the trading group. I paid, I would say, a bit above what was expected, but you know, there was a reason why, because he came with an extra head and accessory. So because I'm posing him with the Marvel Select Red Skull, so scale-wise, he's much larger, so I had to prop Arnim on a DC direct stand. So detail-wise, quite nice. I'm quite satisfied with the figure. I would say this is the money shot, you know, right here. I think as I mentioned previously, the Hasbro BAF figures, not too bad, but not as impressive as, you know, guys like the Onslaught. I mean, it's like size-wise, detail-wise, pales in comparison, but I'm still quite happy nonetheless. That's all I have to talk about this figure. You know, hopefully I get more new arrivals during the rest of the week. So stay tuned. This is a new segment I call Unleashed. So this is where I take mint on card figures and open them up for display, you know, either in an ACBA display or vanilla posing. So here I have a Brightest Day series Deadman. Normally I'm not crazy about DC direct figures, You know, unless they are really unique or there's a particular look from the comic book series that I like. So, I haven't read the Brightest Day series, to be honest. You know, I did read the Blackest Night series, and after a while it got a bit boring because it seemed like a zombie storyline, you know, where the undead go over fresh meat, go after fresh meat, I mean. So I haven't been tempted to pick up the Brightest Day comic books. But having said that, you know, there's something about this figure, you know, which is very unique for DC Direct line of toys. It does come with a lot of accessories. So here you have the White Lantern. So, I mean, obviously, you can tell he's given White Lantern powers. He has a interchangeable head, which is quite unique. Not just for DC Direct figures, but for DC UC figures as well. They rarely come with interchangeable heads. So, he also comes with a spare mask, which is quite nice. So, you know, I was planning to take out this guy to put in an A.C.B.A. display with my DCUC Deadman. So, very obviously, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this guy out and swap heads. So, I'll be back. Okay, so I've cracked open the packaging. Got out the Brightest Day Deadman. So, you know, this is the very first Unleashed segment that I've done. So, a quick review of the DCD figure. Sculpt-wise, it's nice. Nice paint apps. Quite clean. The features, the paint job. But I will have to say I'm a little disappointed for MISB or Minton card figure. The stand was badly scratched. I'm not sure why, considering that this guy was you know, mint inside packaging for ever since I got him. So I can't explain how the stand was so badly scratched, but just a minor detail. The head pops off easily, but there's an issue with a design, you know, the peg is still stuck in the head. So, I've been struggling to get the peg out. In fact, the peg is still stuck in the original mask head. What I have here is just his head resting on the figure without the peg. So, I have to figure out how to get the peg out of the head and onto this unmasked head. But overall, you know, it's quite nice, the detailing. You know, I got the mask into his hand pretty easily. So that's a nice touch. So yeah, I think this will be quite a nice A.C.B.A. display, maybe, you know, something like this. That'll be my money shot. So, okay, that's all for this Deadman review. If you were to ask me whether this is a figure to get, I think other than the minor issue of the pack, I would say he's worth getting. The Wave 1 of the Brightest Day series is yeah, worth getting. You know, figures like the Green Arrow and the Hot Girl are two other figures I have. So, if you have a chance, I would say, yeah, why not? If you don't mind mini statues, get your Brightest Day series 1 figures today. Okay, I finally got the peg out of the mask head and onto the unmasked head. It was a struggle, but I finally found out a good way to get the pack out. So what I did was I used a twisty. I secured it around the bottom of the pack, and I gave it a tug, and voila, the pack came out pretty easily. But subsequently, putting the pack back into the unmasked head was a struggle, but I eventually got it done. So yeah, now at least I feel better, you know, with the head secured, yeah, and not balancing on the neck of the figure. So yeah, I learned something new, so hopefully that tip helps you guys out in the future. Yeah, keep twisties around, you never know when you need them.